You're listening to California's Earthquake Early Warning Notification System.
These are going to be for earthquakes of significance that are going to result in enough shaking.
California already has some 570 earthquake sensors, but when the Napa quake struck 2 years ago, seismologists were unable to get the warning out to the public.
The two sensors closest to the epicenter of the earthquake were not fast enough to contribute to the earthquake early warning system.
But today, the Office of Emergency Services announced $10 million in new state funding, thanks to a bill just signed by Governor Brown. It will nearly double the number of sensors statewide to 1,100, providing fire departments with extra time to react.
Well, minutes or even seconds of early notification could help us take some critical immediate actions, like getting the doors of the station open, pulling rigs out.
And early warnings can also help mass transit systems like BART in dealing with 64 trains during the peak commute.
About 40 of those 64 trains are going to be traveling about 70 miles an hour. If I have 20 seconds of warning, I can reduce that down to 10 miles an hour.
But state officials warned today it will take at least 2 years to roll out the new system, which will take a massive overhaul of technology.
Most people assume that they'll get the earthquake early warning on their cell phone, and that's certainly a goal, but the system is not currently capable of delivering fast notifications to millions of people.
We're used to getting amber alerts on our cell phones, of course, so why not earthquake warnings? Well, state technology experts tell us the cell phone system is not designed to handle fast-speed alerts, the ones needed to save lives during an earthquake.
It's just eye-opening to see right off the top, 59 seconds. Can you imagine how nice that would be? So in the meantime, while we're trying to figure all this out, what kind of warnings would we get and how would we get those?
Well, probably satellite, TV, radio, internet, and other functions, of course, but we're still years away from developing new cell phones that are actually capable of receiving these fast-speed alerts in real time.
As they say, it's not a matter of if, but when.
Exactly.
So looking forward. Thank you, Mike.
You bet.